Hello students, welcome to you all. Let us start the topic oxidation and reduction reaction. Students, oxidation and reduction reaction, when both occur, it is known as the redox reaction. Redox with formed by the red and ox. Red means reduction and ox means oxidation. So reduction, redox reaction or those reaction where the oxidation and reduction both reaction is going on. Fine. So let's start. What is oxidation and what is reduction reaction? Clear? Students, oxidation reaction. Oxidation reaction is where the gaining of oxygen, you can say addition of oxygen, removal of hydrogen, either you can say losing of hydrogen, and the loss of electrons, which is our electronic based concept. So this is known as oxidation. Oxidation means where oxygen add, where hydrogen remove, and where the electrons lose is known as oxidation reaction. Reduction reaction means it's just opposite of the oxidation reaction, that is losing of oxygen, where the removal of the oxygen. Second, gaining of hydrogen, that means addition of the hydrogen. And the third, gain of electrons. It is an electronic based concept again. So this is known as the reduction. Oxidation and reduction, both reaction will be going on, because if one substance is removing the oxygen, it means another substance will take the oxygen, will gain the oxygen. So here oxidation and reduction, both reaction will be going on, and this type of reaction is known as redox reaction. Clear? So oxidation, that is in your syllabus, gaining and removing you have to go through, but the loss of electrons and gain of electrons, it is in your upper classes. Fine. So now let's see the example. How can we find where the oxidation is going on and where the reduction is going on? Is it clear? Let's see, students, the first example I have taken, that is Fe2O3 plus 2 air. It forms 2 FeAl2O3. As we know, it is a left hand side and this one is a right hand side. Left hand side, it is a reactant part, and right hand side, it is a product part. One thing always you remember, always we see the reactant two products. Always we observe the reactant side. Is it clear? Here, students, you see Fe2O3. Fine? Fe2O3, and here in product 2 Fe only is there. That means Fe2O3 remove the oxygen. Remove oxygen. Is it clear? Here aluminium forms in product Al2O3, which is aluminium oxide. That means gaining of oxygen. It is gaining of oxygen. Here removal of oxygen, here gaining of oxygen. So according to the concept, students, removal of oxygen, removal of oxygen means losing of oxygen, or losing of oxygen is known as reduction. So this is reduction. Okay, we observe from reactant to product Fe2O3 remove the oxygen, and it form Fe, where the reduction is going on, and that process is reduction. And here aluminium gain the oxygen and form the aluminium oxide. It means here aluminium taking the oxygen which has removed by the Fe2O3. So it is known as the gaining of oxygen, and it is known as oxidation. This is oxidation. Is it clear, students? So removal of oxygen, reduction, and gaining of oxygen, that means addition of oxygen, it is known as oxidation. So it is a redox reaction also. Why? Because reduction and oxidation reaction both going on. Clear? Now second, zinc oxide plus carbon, it forms zinc to carbon monoxide. Let's see here, when we see the zinc oxide to zinc, yes, what is going? Again you will observe here, there is the removal of oxygen, 5. Here carbon forms the carbon monoxide due to the addition of oxygen. Is it clear? So removal of oxygen, which is reduction, right? And addition of oxygen, which is oxidation. Clear, students? So this is the way which we have to find the oxidation and reduction reaction. Now next one, the example is hydrogen sulfide react with chlorine and form the sulfur plus hydrogen chloride. Fine. So here let's see S2S2S. What is going? Here S2S. Now in product only S is there. That means hydrogen is not there. So we can say it is the removal of hydrogen. It is a removal of hydrogen. Clear? Now let's see here. Cl2 to SCl. Fine. Here you observe there is the addition of hydrogen. Clear, students? So removal of hydrogen is known as, according to the concept, removal of hydrogen is known as oxidation. And the addition of hydrogen, it means gaining of hydrogen. So it is known as reduction. So both example I have given is students where the removal and addition of the oxygen is going, and here the addition and removal of hydrogen is going. Now let's see students, here that is concept of oxidation and reduction. But there is the problem facing the students is that how we can find the oxidizing agent and reducing agent. So simple way I am describing to you, I am explaining to you, and you try to understand the things. Fine. So oxidizing agent and reducing agent. Students, oxidizing agent. Point to be remember which I am explaining. A substance which undergo oxidation act as reducing agent. That means a substance which undergo oxidation is known as reducing agent. Fine. Similarly, a substance which undergo reduction is known as oxidizing agent. का मतलब कि जिसका रिडक्शन होता है वो उसका ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एजेंट है, और जिसका ऑक्सीडेशन हो रहा है वो उसका रिड्यूसिंग एजेंट है. लेट्स सी द एग्जांपल हियर स्टूडेंट्स. Fe2O3 to Fe. हियर व्हाट इज गोइंग? रिमूवल ऑफ ऑक्सीजन, दैट मींस रिडक्शन हो रहा है. कहां हो रहा है रिडक्शन? किसने रिड्यूस किया, किसने रिमूव किया ऑक्सीजन को? Fe2O3 ने रिमूव किया. इसका मतलब यहाँ पे रिडक्शन हो रहा है, तो ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एजेंट कौन हुआ? जिसने रिमूव किया. दो सब्सटेंसेस विच रिमूव द ऑक्सीजन वेयर द रिडक्शन इज गोइंग ऑन, दैट सब्सटेंस इज नोन एज ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एजेंट. सो हियर इन फर्स्ट एग्जांपल Fe2O3 इट इज एक्ट एज ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एजेंट. व्हाई? बिकॉज Fe2O3 थेरेपी द रिडक्शन इज गोइंग. So I explained that a substance which undergo oxidation is known as reducing agent, and the substance which undergo reduction is known as oxidizing agent. So here reduction is going on, so Fe2O3 is a oxidizing agent. Now where the reducing agent, this substance is act as a reducing agent. Let's see here students. Aluminium to aluminium oxide. Aluminium gaining the oxygen which is reduced by the iron. Is it clear? So gaining the, who gain? Aluminium gain. Where it is oxidized? Aluminium is going to oxidize, and it is a oxidation. So that aluminium is known as reducing agent. Point to be remember the students, always we observe the reactant side. Nobody will see the product side. because in some cases the students are writing L2O3 is a reducing agent, which is wrong. It is also L2O3, it is already oxidized. But initially, who is going to oxidize? That is aluminium. Fine. तो जिसका रिडक्शन होगा वो उसका ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एजेंट और जिसका ऑक्सीडेशन होता है वो उसका रिड्यूसिंग एजेंट. हमेशा याद रखिएगा आप लोग. लेसन अगेन नेक्स्ट एग्जांपल जिंक ऑक्साइड टू जिंक. सो हियर रिमूवल ऑफ ऑक्सीजन रिडक्शन हो रहा है. हु रिड्यूस द ऑक्सीजन? जिंक ऑक्साइड रिड्यूस द ऑक्सीजन, नॉट अ जिंक. बिकॉज जिंक इज नॉट हैविंग ऑक्सीजन, तो हाउ द जिंक विल रिड्यूस? इज इट क्लियर? सो हु रिड्यूस? जिंक ऑक्साइड. So zinc oxide act as a oxidizing agent because the reduction is going on. Now the next thing, C to CO. Clear? Who oxidizes? CO oxidizes? No, CO is already having oxygen. C is going to oxidize. C mein O add ho raha hai, now ki CO mein add ho raha hai. Fine. So here oxidation going on. So this C it is known as reducing agent. Now I hope students it is clear. Again here oxidation, so H2O acid is a reducing agent and chlorine addition of hydrogen reduction, so chlorine is a oxidizing agent. Clear? So these are the things which I have explained, ki what is oxidation and reduction reaction and how you can find the oxidizing and reducing agent in the given equation or reaction. Students, always one point, remember it, always be of the reactant side, focus on the reactant side, then go to the product. These are the things which I have explained today, what is oxidation reduction reaction and how we can find the oxidizing and reducing agents. So do the practice of the question, more and more questions, if you see good questions also, and if any problem ask to me. Thank you and have a nice day.